everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Well, I think we can safely say that summer's just about gone. The days are shorter now and the evenings cool. It's time for parties, for bridge and gay gatherings at home. And more than ever, it's the time for Horlicks. A lot of you found last year what a welcome change Horlicks makes for the party guest who wants something more than the usual coffee, tea, or plain milk. Horlicks has everything a perfect hostess could want. It's easy to make. That means it won't interfere with the bridge game. Just mix thoroughly with water or milk and it's ready to serve. Then it's different, too. Delicious, wholesome, sustaining, with a flavor all its own. It won't keep your guests awake when they get home, like coffee so often does. There's many a guest who'd really appreciate that. Get some Horlicks now, ready for your next party. You have a choice of two flavors, you know, either natural or chocolate. And ladies and gentlemen, here's an important announcement regarding change in schedule of the Lum and Abner program. So many of you have requested it that new coast stations have been added and the time of the broadcast changed. Beginning next Monday, October 21st, your old friends Lum and Abner will come to you in person at 8:15 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Be sure and check your local newspaper for the new schedule and the additional stations. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. You know, Lum has been arrested, charged with violating the Blue Sky Law, and is now out on bond until his trial comes up next week. He has been given to understand through very reliable sources that his only chance for an acquittal is to produce Squire Skimp, the promoter of the fraudulent stock, in time for the trial. Yesterday, Lum received word that Squire had been arrested in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and would be returned to Pine Ridge today. As we look in on our old friends today, Abner has gone to the county seat to bring Squire back. And we find Grandpappy Spears over at Lum's house discussing the affair with Lum. Listen.
Well, I just hope Abner don't have no trouble with him. It'd be a shame for him to make a getaway after you went to all this trouble to catch him and bring him back here. Well, I ain't uneasy about that. I'm just worried feared Abner'll be too rough with him. He's so mad, I'm just feared Squire'll make some move where Abner thinks he's trying to get away and start shooting. He's pretty mad, huh? Oh, yeah. He hates that Squire anyway, you know. Special now after this is all came up. Well, you can't blame him. Squire caused you and Abner enough trouble the last 2 or 3 years. Yeah, I look back now, I can see where he's taking advantage of us time and again. No telling how much money he's beat us out of on different deals. Well, I know, that's what I say. He's mine and I made his living off of you, too. Yeah, well, it's been a good lesson to us, I'll tell you that. I'll know now better than to have any dealings with a fella like that. Yeah, he's a smooth talker, all right. I always just stop up my ears whenever he starts trying to sell me anything. Well, ain't no need to do that. From here out, I'll just beat him at his own game. You know that old Eddard saying, it takes a crook to beat a crook. No, that's something else. Huh? Nothing, I don't aim to be beat out of no more money, though, I'll tell you that. Well, I don't reckon anybody will be for a while now. Huh? Oh, no. 10 or 15 years anyway. Listen, he gets to selling stock in something to them other fellas there in the penitentiary. Well, he would now if he got a chance, I'll tell you that. He about swapped the warden 2 or 3 shares of stock in some company to getting up for a pardon.
Yeah.
He's a sight, that feller. He's got a face on him as kind and innocent looking as somebody's old grandma, and he can look you right smack in the eye and tell you something you know ain't a word of truth in, but you can't keep from believing it. Wait a minute. Who's that driving up out there in front?
Yeah, looks like Frank Foster's car.
Well, that's Abner and Squire then. Yeah, he got Frank to drive him in there.
Yeah, there's Abner getting out of the car.
Now, Granny's, wait a minute here. Where's Squire?
Huh? Well, I'll be dad blamed. He ain't with Abner, is he? Frank's driving off there.
Well, I'll swan to goodness. Do you reckon that crazy idiot let Squire get away from him?
I told you somebody ought to went along with him, Mom.
Here he comes. My grannies, I ought to had more sense than to leave it up to him in the first place. Now then, we've got the whole thing to do over again. Dad, blame it, if I don't tell him a thing or two. Wait a minute. So you let him get away, huh? Anybody that can't bring a prisoner from the county seat out here without letting him get away ought to be thrown out of office.
Hey, who was it got away? I hadn't heard about it.
Come on in.
Let's hear what kind of excuse you've got studied up.
Excuse for what? What are you talking about?
Why, where about the Squire Skimp at?
Oh, why, we let him out over at his place. He wanted to run in and see his woman in a minute. He'll be on over here directly, he said.
You mean you just turned him loose and let him go in the house by himself?
No, I ain't turned him loose. He knows he's still under E-Red.
Well, for goodness sake.
I bound he's aiming on making a getaway.
Why, sure he is. About went out the back door before you got out of sight. Swan Abner, you got less sense when it comes to handling criminals.
Oh, well, now, Squire ain't gonna try to get away. He told me he's glad to come back. He wanted to stand trial. Wants a chance to prove that he ain't guilty.
Yeah, it's just a lot of mouth talk.
No, sir, he says if he'd have known we was looking for him, he'd have been back here long ago of his own accord.
He claims he's innocent?
Yes, sir. I don't know but what I believe him, too.
He ain't denying it. He sold a lot of that mining stock around here, is he?
Oh, no, no. He admits to that all right. But you just ain't heard his side of it. He says the folks here in town just made up all this stuff on him because he weren't here to defend himself.
Sassy Fresh. He's guilty and he knows it.
Well, he says that the mine's all right. That the whole trouble is, Lum just don't know how to manage it.
He said that about me?
That's what he said.
I granny, I'll make him take them remarks back. Every last one of them. Trying to lay the blame on me, huh? Talking about me in back of myself, is he? If you want my notions on it, he's halfway back to the county seat by this time. You don't have a chance to make him take nothing back.
Why, he's right over at his place. Said he'd be on over here directly.
Wait a minute. I'll find out if he's over there or not. And if he ain't, it's up to you to find him. Fine, constable. Turn all the criminals loose. You're worth not having none at all. Wait, hello?
Blow me out for something.
Miss Kim? Let me speak to Squire a minute, please, Ma.
Squire's right there at his place.
He ain't. Oh, my goodness, that's all I want to know. Goodbye. Now, there you are. That blamed I knowed, I
well,
knowed.
He promised me on his word, Lum, and he wouldn't.
Wait a minute, Lum. There he is. There's Squire coming in the gate out there. Huh? Well, I'll be dope.
I told you he said he'd be on
that's
over.
That's all right, Abner. I ain't mad about it. We've got him located again. I hope you make him admit he's guilty, Lum. I wouldn't let him try to lay the blame off on me if I was you. Well, don't you worry. I just been awaiting to meet him face to face again. Come in.
Well, howdy, Squire.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Good afternoon.
Come right in, Squire.
And Lum and Gramps have been jumping on me for letting you stop over at your place, Squire. They thought you was going to try to run off.
Why, we never. We just,
Oh, no, no, man. I'm glad of the opportunity to come back and prove my innocence to my good friends here in Pine Ridge. I was astonished to learn that all this had come up since I left town.
And you sort of left me to face the whole thing by myself, Squire. It got me charged with violating a blue sky law. Claim that stock we sold weren't no count. I had to mortgage my place and everything else to raise money enough to pay back the stockholders with.
Well, now, don't you worry about that one minute, Lum. You'll get every cent of it back, I'll promise you that.
You mean you'll pay me back what I had to give the stockholders?
Yes, sir, every nickel of it, with interest.
Well, I'll be damned by
it. Why, I've got a deal on over in Tulsa that'll make me more money in the next few weeks than I'll know what to do with. I took that money that we got from a sale of stock in our silver mine and invested it in this new proposition. And it is a winner or my name ain't Skimp.
What sort of a business is it, Squire?
Well, of course, I couldn't afford to divulge any of the secrets of it, Lum, unless you were a stockholder in the company. But I will tell you this. It's a patent I bought.
A patent?
One of the greatest discoveries of this age. Synthetic gasoline.
What kind of gasoline?
Synthetic, substitute gasoline that can be made in your own home in 2 minutes.
What?
Secret powder formula, 2 teaspoonsful of which will transform a gallon of ordinary water into a gallon of pure high-test gasoline.
Well, that's foreign to goodness. Just 2 teaspoonsful, huh?
It's just 2, mind you. I tell you, men, it'll revolutionize all industry. It's the greatest discovery since Benjamin Franklin discovered electricity.
Yeah, that sounds all right, don't it?
Why, the patent rights alone are worth millions. The major oil companies would pay a fortune for it. Why, gentlemen, when I turn this loose on the markets of the world, it'll mean the ruination of the oil industry.
Aye, Granny, I'd love to get in on a deal like that just once. I'll swan, Squire, you're the luckiest fella I ever seen to have something like
well,
that.
Well, I don't know of anybody I'd rather have in with me than you, Lum.
Yeah.
Well, but, of course, I wouldn't want to influence you in any way in buying it.
No, no.
I've got to have $50 to send to Washington for the patent rights, and I've got 25 of that 50.
Well, I granted you've got the other 25, too. I'll raise it some way. Just count me in on it.
Well, good for you, Lum. I told Squire coming out here that I figured you'd go in with us on it.
Oh, did you buy some stock in it, too, Abner?
Why, sure. I was the one that put up the $25 that Squire's already got. I know that's the best proposition I ever had.
Well, it looks like that when Squire Skimp offers them a proposition, Lum and Abner just can't say no. Ladies and gentlemen, I've often told you about the dealer who tries to substitute. Well, I went shopping for Horlicks myself the other day just to see what would happen. Here's what did take place, just as I expected. Listen. I want a package of Horlicks, please.
Yes, sir. Natural or chocolate?
Natural, I think.
All right. But really, sir, I think you're making a mistake.
Oh, you don't say.
Yes, sir. Horlicks is good, of course. But really, our brand is good, too. Just as good. And much cheaper.
Well, is that so?
Yes, sir. You take our brand. Very good. I'll write
now, just a minute there. I never said anything about taking your brand. I want Horlicks, please. What I ask for. I happen to know that Horlicks is more than worth that difference in cost. And, my friends, it's unbelievable the way some stores attempt to push products that are far inferior to Horlicks. I happen to know that the product offered me as just as good as Horlicks was really a mechanical mixture of inferior malt powder, skim milk, and more than 50% ordinary sugar. Surely that's no bargain. Where your health's concerned, you just can't afford to take a chance. Insist on Horlicks, the original. Then you know that you'll be getting a product of quality, flavor, and results that have never been equaled. And now don't forget, new coast stations have been added and the time of this program changed. Beginning next Monday, October 21st, your old friends Lum and Abner will come to you in person at 8:15 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Be sure and check your local newspaper for the new schedule and the additional stations. This is Carlton Brickert, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all goodbye until Monday at this same time.